Today, we're diving into the incredible life of Tupac Shakur. He wasn't just one of the most iconic rappers of all time, but also a man who broke barriers in so many ways. Tupac's music spoke about life, struggles, and hope, touching millions around the world. But what many people don't know is that Tupac wasn't just a musician. He was also a smart businessman with big dreams beyond music. In this video, we'll look at his journey from his rise to fame to his plans for financial success. Let's explore the life and legacy of Tupac Shakur. Before we dive in, make sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications for latest updated. Tupac Shakur was born in New York City in 1971. He grew up in a family that was deeply involved in social activism. His mother, Afeni Shakur, was a member of the Black Panther Party, which fought for the rights of African Americans. This environment taught Tupac about the struggles of Black people in America from a young age. Later, his family moved to Baltimore, where he attended the Baltimore School for the Art. It was here that Tupac discovered his love for acting, poetry, and music, setting the stage for the incredible career that was to come. Tupac's music career began when he joined Digital Underground as a backup dancer and rapper, gaining early exposure. His first solo album, Tupacalypse, now 1991, made an impact with socially conscious songs like Brenda's Got a Mint, Baby, and Trapped, addressing poverty, violence, and systemic issues. This album sold over 500,000 copies in the U.S., valued around $1 million. His second album, Strictly For My Nigga, 1993, boosted his fame with party anthems like I Get Around and the empowering Keep Your Head Up. It sold over 800,000 copies, worth approximately $1.6 million. In 1995, Tupac released Me Against the World while serving time in prison, featuring the emotional hit Dear Mama. This album became his first to reach number one on the Billboard 200, making him the first artist to achieve this. While incarcerated, it sold over 3 million copies, valued at around $6 million. Tupac's most significant success came with All Eyes on Me, 1996, his first double album under Death Row Records. This album became a massive hit, selling over 10 million copies, worth about $20 million, with iconic tracks like California Love and How Do You Want It. Later that year, he released The Don Caluminati, The 7-Day Theory under the name Machiavelli, featuring intense songs like Hail Mary. This album sold over 5 million copies, valued at around $10 million, and reflected his complex character. Tupac's blend of socially charged lyrics, powerful storytelling, and charisma made him a voice for an entire generation, contributing to his status as one of the best-selling music artists, with over 75 million albums sold worldwide, generating substantial revenue for his estate. In addition to his music, Tupac had a successful acting career, showcasing his versatility as a performer. He made his film debut in Juice, 1992, playing the troubled character Bishop, which earned him critical acclaim. He followed this with notable roles in films like Poetic Justice, 1993, alongside Janet Jackson, and Above the Rim, 1994. Where he played a streetwise basketball player. His acting career earned him approximately $3 million overall. Tupac's ability to portray gritty, emotional characters added depth to his on-screen persona and helped expand his influence beyond music. He had plans to continue acting, but his career was tragically cut short. Tupac's personal life was full of complexity. He shared a deep bond with his mother, Afeni Shakur, and was known for his passion for social justice, influenced by his family's activism. However, his life was marked by legal trouble. In 1994, Tupac was convicted of sexual assault and sentenced to prison. His time in jail became a turning point as he signed with Death Row Records while incarcerated. Tupac also faced multiple run-ins with the law, including assault and weapons charge. These incidents often fueled his thug life persona, which he both embraced and critiqued. The most infamous part of Tupac's personal life was his involvement in the East Coast versus West Coast rap rivalry. Tensions between Tupac and the right, Notorious B.I.G., escalated after Tupac was shot in a New York studio in 1994. Tupac accused Biggie and his team of being involved, further deepening the divide between the East Coast, led by Bad Boy Records, and West Coast, led by Death Row Records. Tupac's song Hit 'Em Up directly attacked Biggie, and the rivalry continued to boil over in the media. Despite the controversy surrounding his life, Tupac had a softer side. He was known for his poetry, which he published in his book The Rose That Grew From Concrete. He also had plans to help uplift his community with ideas of starting youth programs and projects aimed at giving back to disadvantaged neighborhoods. Tupac's life was tragically cut short when he was shot in a drive-by shooting in Las Vegas in 1996. His death remains unsolved and continues to spark debate and conspiracy theory, adding to the complexity of his legacy. Beyond music, Tupac had a sharp business mind. He aimed to gain more control over his career by founding Machiavelli Records, a label where he could sign and promote artists. Tupac also had plans to start a film production company and expand his influence in Hollywood. He was looking into real estate investments and other ventures to build generational wealth. His vision included creating opportunities for his community, showing that he wanted to use his success to uplift others, both financially and socially. Though his life was cut short, Tupac's estate continues to manage his brand, ensuring his music and image remain influential. His business legacy still generates revenue posthumously through album sales, documentaries, and licensing deals. Tupac Shakur's life was a powerful blend of artistry and ambition. His influence as a rapper, actor, and entrepreneur continues to resonate today. He dreamed of uplifting his community and creating lasting change, proving that his impact goes far beyond music. If you want to dive deeper into Tupac's legacy and explore his works, make sure to like, subscribe, and share. Your thoughts in the comments below. Let's keep the conversation going about this remarkable icon.